There's been some buzz lately about a new keyboard feature introduced by manufacturers like Razer and Wooting. Razer calls it Snapped Up on their keyboards, and Wooting calls it SOCD. SOCD is the more generic term that's been in use in the fighting game community for a decade, so it probably makes sense to call it that. Let me show you how you can add this feature to any keyboard without installing any software on your computer using HID Remapper. The feature has been in the news recently because of the advantage it gives you in certain FPS games like Counter-Strike. What it does is it changes the keyboard's behavior when certain two keys are pressed simultaneously. This can of course be applied to any two keys, but since it's most relevant in the context of FPS games that commonly use the WASD keys for movement, let's say we're interested in the A and D keys, which are typically mapped to strafing, or moving your character left and right. On any normal keyboard, when you press A and D simultaneously, or any other two keys simultaneously for that matter, it will just send that information to the computer. It will say that both A and D keys are pressed. The new SOCD feature changes that behavior. It makes it so that from the computer's point of view, the keys are never pressed simultaneously, even though in physical reality they are. Depending on the mode and the order in which the keys were pressed, the keyboard either tells the computer that only one of the keys is pressed, or that neither of the keys is pressed. SOCD stands for Simultaneous Opposing Cardinal Directions, meaning left and right, or up and down, pressed together. So this process is more accurately called SOCD cleaning or SOCD resolution. Because of how the input systems on some games work, specifically first-person shooters, this offers a significant advantage to the player. I won't go into detail about the specifics, there are other videos that explain it better than I could. What I am going to do though, is I'm going to show you how you can add that feature to any keyboard in hardware. Of course, we could do it in software, and people have been doing it in software long before Razer decided to make it a firmware feature on their keyboards. But if you're familiar with the HID Remapper project, you know that we like to do things like this in hardware. HID Remapper is a universal adapter for USB input devices. It lets you do things like remap keys, define macros, make keyboards work as mice, and a lot of other cool stuff. Let me show you how you can use it to add the SOCD feature to any keyboard. HID Remapper comes in many shapes and sizes. Here I have a custom PCB, but it can also be made using a Raspberry Pi Pico, or you can just buy this ready-to-use board from Adafruit that looks like this. Okay. Instead of plugging my keyboard directly into my computer, I'm going to plug it into the HID Remapper. And plug the HID Remapper into my computer. By default, it just passes everything through transparently. The A key works normally, the D key works normally, and when I press them both together, the computer sees that both are pressed. Okay. Let's configure the HID Remapper to apply SOCD cleaning to those keys. To configure HID Remapper, you go to this website in your browser. You don't have to install any software on your computer. Let's connect to our HID Remapper. Open device, select our device, connect. We could, of course, configure everything manually, but I'm going to go to the Examples tab and load the configuration preset. As you can see, there's a lot of different example configurations here. First, I'm going to load the neutral SOCD configuration. This is what the configuration looks like. The behavior of the A and D keys is defined by expressions 1 and 2. Here's what the expressions look like. If you want to know more about how they work, check out the project's documentation. They're essentially little programs with their own weird syntax. Let's save this configuration to our HID remapper, save to device, and let's see how the keys work now. Now when I press the A and D keys by themselves, they still work as usual. But when I press the two of them together, you can see that the computer thinks I'm not pressing any of them. HID remapper saw that both of them are pressed and applied the SOCD cleaning rules that we defined in the expressions that we just saw. This is called neutral SOCD. Let's try some other modes. Let's load the last input priority configuration. Save it to our HID remapper. And let's see how it works now. Now when I press and hold A, and then press D while still holding A, the computer thinks I'm only pressing D, even though I'm actually still pressing both keys. This mode is called last input priority, because between the two keys, the one that was pressed last wins. If I release D, A is pressed again, as expected. This lets us do tricks like quickly alternate between left and right by holding one of the keys and tapping the other key, which is easier and quicker to do than pressing and releasing both keys. This is the mode that is said to offer the greatest benefit in some games. For completeness, let's also try the first input priority mode. Let's save it to our HID remapper. And let's see how it works now. Now when I press and hold A and press D, the computer thinks I'm only pressing A. This is because in this mode, the key that was pressed first wins. When I release A, now D is pressed. If I press A again while still holding D, the computer doesn't see that, it still only sees D. Okay, that is it for now. If this sounds interesting to you, check out the project's GitHub repository. If you'd like to get your own HID remapper, there's a video that gives you all the options. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.